What's happening, everybody? Trey here, and today at Reactions to the Classics, gonna be reacting to some Megadeth here, and gonna tackle one of their more acclaimed tunes, so I'm looking forward to that. I'm gonna be reacting today to Holy Wars, The Punishment Due, the opener to their highly acclaimed 1990 record, Rust in Peace here. I wanna shout out our longtime patron and friend and metalhead of the channel, Ryan, for suggesting this one for me to dive into today, and enough talk, man. Let's just get into it. Reading the some of the facts about it on Wikipedia definitely has me intrigued, and I think this is just going to be an absolute epic here. I'm not too familiar with Megadeth. I've heard a few tunes from Ryan, from what he's brought on our live streams that we do on YouTube and Twitch. Be sure to check those out, man. They're always a good time listening and discovering new music. So the structure of the song is said to start off really fast, thrashy, as you'd kind of expect just from the Megadeth I know, but then transitions to a bit of an acoustic bridge here, and then goes to a heavier section called The Punishment Due, interspersed by two guitar solos played by Marty Friedman, before speeding up again with a third and final solo played during the Punishment Due segment by Dave Mustaine. The entire song is commonly referred to as Holy Wars, with The Punishment Due referring to the heavier, slower section. And lyrically, it's going to get a bit political, man, dealing with global religious conflict, especially in Israel and Northern Ireland. And Dave Mustaine said that he was inspired to write the song in Northern Ireland when he discovered bootlegged Megadeth t-shirts that were on sale, but he was dissuaded from taking action to have them removed on the basis that they were part of fundraising activities for the cause, the Provisional Irish Republican Army. Punishment Due is based on the Punisher, Marvel character, who's pretty awesome, man. Pretty awesome. So I'm looking forward to it, man. All that to say, let's just dive into this. I have the lyrics pulled up in front of me. Just going to follow along, take in the song, and give my thoughts at the end. So thanks again, Ryan. Let's get it. I love it, man. We're just diving right into that thrashy, high-speed sound. Bringing the heat, man. We ain't even a minute into this. Really loving the drumming on this as well, too. Energy personified. Thank you. Powerful lyricism, man, to go with the powerful music to boot. Really enjoying this so far, man. Alright, here's that Friedman solo. Kind of going back to what the intro was like. Ridiculous. Holy War's The Punishment, dude. What an epic tune. What a way to start off your record as well, man. Tough to follow that, I imagine, but I'm sure Megadeth pulled it off, man. Definitely piqued my interest to listen to Rust in Peace. Starting off, man, with the very fast-paced guitar, the drumming by Nick Menza as well, especially in that first section, was so impressive to me, man. Just a bolt of energy, man, that ejected right into your ears, man. Got you ready for what was about to transpire, man. Love the riffs, especially in the beginning as well. Throughout the whole song, they're great and so fast-paced, man. As soon as you kind of get the riff in your head, they switch it up to something else, man. This is one that I think is going to reward repeated listens as in addition to that. So we have that instrumental intro before going into the lyricism. First couple verses, as we kind of noted at the start, talking about the holy wars, if you will, the way that religion has been used throughout time to kind of exert your will, to be violent in the name of your God, so to speak here, man. He says, fools like me who cross the sea and come to foreign lands. Ask the sheep for their beliefs. Do you kill on God's command? A country that's divided surely will not stand. My past a race, no more disgrace, no foolish, naive stand. And I just got a shout out too, man. The vocal delivery by Dave Mustaine here, and the lyricism as well. A very powerful tune in any genre, let alone, you know, I think sometimes people who aren't into metal, like, just maybe dismiss it quite easily. I notice that a lot with hip-hop as well, and both of those genres just have some tremendous songwriting that really touches, I think, a populace and a people that your pop music, you know, that you hear on the radio is not going to do, man. Gets heavy in this song, in the lyricism, which I think it needed to be, man, to reflect just the instrumental that was going underneath it as well. He notes the end is near, it's crystal clear, part of the master plan. Don't look now to Israel, it might be your homeland. Holy wars. I think he's saying in that, like, what's happening with Israel and Palestine has been, you know, going on forever, but that holy war aspect could come and come to your homeland, if you will. And I don't think he's too far off on that regard, man. And I say this as a about, you know, Christian, man. There's so many times people just try to twist God and his word and try to use it for their own gain. And you know, kind of reminds me of the Bob Dylan tune Masters of War, man. They're the masters of war to sit around, say they're, you know, you go here, you kill this person, you attack that country, while they're sitting safe and just calling all the shots. So I think that first part really was powerful. And then we did get that mini acoustic bridge. It was quite quick. Part of me wish it was even longer. And then we go to that punishment due portion right there, where, you know, it slows down a little from that thrashiness, and yet still keeps the heavy riffs going. Still kind of keeps that death-like imagery up at the forefront. He notes, some people risk to employ me, some people live to destroy me. Either way, they die, which, knowing some of the backstory of the Punisher comic book character, it kind of, you can kind of see that in there. They killed my wife and my baby with hopes to enslave me. First mistake, last mistake. I do like this, man. I do like just how forthcoming the lyricism is. Like, yeah, you came after me, you might have got me, but watch out, because you're gonna be next and you ain't gonna escape. Then we had a couple just blistering solos here by Marty Friedman, and man, he just absolutely destroyed these solos. It was ridiculous, man. Just ones that just melt your face off, so to speak. I just quite enjoyed them, and yet again wish they'd gone a little bit longer before kind of finishing with that final verse. What an epic song right here. I want to shout out Ryan for suggesting this for me to dive into today. And I mean, there's so much I didn't even touch on, but definitely had to give the old heart, man. We'll be spinning this on repeat, and you know, gotta dive into some Megadeth, man. Gotta jump into the metal pool, the classic metal pool right here, man. So let me know what you think of this song and this record. Be sure to give Ryan some love. If you'd like to have me react to a song for you, you can check out our Patreon page, which is linked below, and will also be on the end screen, along with another video you might enjoy. Got some Iron Maiden reactions up here as well that I quite enjoyed that Ryan suggested. But until next time, y'all, thanks so much for watching. Happy listening, and I will see ya.